The lawyer releases a copy of the graft complaint filed against Energy Secretary Alfonso Cusi and Davao businessman Dennis Uy over the controversial Malampaya deal. Rico Domingo, the lawyer of complainants, showed the copy dated October 18. This means the complaint against Cusi and Uy were filed prior to the publication of media reports refuting claims of Cusi and Uy's lawyer that there was no complaint at the time the reports were published. Cusi and Uy filed cyber libel cases against several news organizations, including ABS-CBN, the parent firm of this news channel, over what they call malicious reporting on the Malampaya deals.
Kung ang kanilang nire-report lamang ay tunay na sinabi sa criminal complaint at wala nang iba, they're not editorializing, and it is a pure reportorial of what had been alleged and averred in the criminal complaint, then walang problema ang journalist. Under the law, dapat may prior approval ng DOE at dapat may due diligence on the financial, legal, and the technical qualifications of the transferee or the assignee. They did not do that.
Meanwhile, journalist groups insist that regardless when the formal graft complaint against Cusi and Uy was filed, there was still nothing libelous in the stories written about them.
Most of them, at least the ones that I was able to read, were just straight news stories. There was absolutely no basis on the part of Mr. Cusi to say that he has been maligned, unduly maligned, by the articles.
At the time of the reporting, whether there was a formal complaint or none is beside the point. This is a matter of public interest and therefore a matter for media reporting and commentary. And the media were not quoting any ghost sources, they were quoting people who were prepared to come forward and pursue their allegations. And the media went to the other side and asked for it. So what's anomalous about the whole thing?
The two also believe this latest libel suit will spur journalists to be more tenacious in doing their job.
If Mr. Cusi thinks that there will be less reports about him with his decision to file criminal libel charges against journalists, he's mistaken. Oh, mas lalo niyang kuan eh, mas lalo niyang ginatungan yung issue.
Philippine House lawmakers approve a bill declaring the country's maritime zones amid rising tensions with China in the West Philippine Sea. The measure aims to establish the legal basis by which social, economic, commercial, and other activities may be connected in these zones. House Committee on Foreign Affairs Chair Ann Hofer says the approval marks an important step towards consolidating the country's maritime jurisdiction as declared in the 2016 Arbitral Award. The bill is now headed to the Senate. Just recently, tensions between the country and China flared up again after a Chinese patrol ship chased off a Philippine Navy vessel resupplying forces stationed at the Yunnan Shoal.
In other news, China's influence in the Indo-Pacific region wanes as the UN gains ground. That's according to the latest Asia Power Index of Sydney, a Sydney-based think tank Lowy Institute. The index showed China fell to second place after losing 1.5 points in its overall score. The index is based on 8 categories, including military capability, economic resources, and diplomatic influence. The U.S., on the other hand, topped 6 of the 8 measures, registering its first annual gain in comprehensive power since the Institute began publishing the index in 2018. The index also showed almost all countries lost power amid the COVID pandemic in terms of their capacity to respond to and shape the external environment. But the U.S. was a rare exception. As for the Philippines, it's at the middle of the list, the country's overall score contracting 0.2 points. The country performed best in the defense networks measure, but ranked low, the 20th place in the resilience measure, which the study said reflected poor levels of internal stability. The U.S. announces a diplomatic boycott of the 2022 Beijing Olympics. This means Washington will not send any diplomatic or official representation to the event. President Joe Biden was already mulling the move since last month in protest of China's human rights record, including what he described as the genocide against minority Muslims in the western region of Xinjiang.
But this is just sending a message that, given these human rights abuses, we cannot proceed with business as usual.
China's Washington embassy, meanwhile, dismissed America's diplomatic boycott as a pretentious act that would have no impact on the holding of the Games. Beijing also reiterating that no invitation has been extended to U.S. politicians for the event.